feels a little. Okay, so go figure, I like the way it feels best on my butt. Welcome to my channel or welcome back to my channel. I have some PR to test, and it is the Radiant Spin Care System. It looks like this. I said yes to this because I was so intrigued. I've always been intrigued by these products like the Clarisonic, kind of a spin-off, no pun intended. It's kind of a spin-off of the Clarisonic. And this also brought up, I've always kind of intuitively felt like they probably aren't the best thing for our skin. If you guys have one of your own, a Clarisonic or another brand, leave a comment below. Let me know what your experience has been. I'm super curious. I have not tested this out. I'm gonna be doing a first impression with you. I wanted to try this. I said, yes, go ahead and send it to me. There's a code below. It's a huge discount. It's like 70% off. It retails for $95 and it's 70% off if you use the code in the description box below. But we're gonna get into this a little bit. There are some pros and there are some cons to this for sure. I have never tried one of these, and intuitively I've always kind of felt like they could be too harsh for our skin. I do think that physical exfoliation is something to be handled very carefully and to not overdo. I am also going to be leaving some links below to some videos about exfoliation and the skin barrier and all of that. And they are going to be links to videos done by dermatologist doctors. Dr. Dre, she's a very big YouTuber. I think she has almost 500,000 subscribers. She's touched on the whole thing with exfoliation and potential damage that you can do with doing too much physical exfoliation. I have always felt like I have dry skin. If you've been watching me, you know that. And by the way, if you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing. I would really like that. Introduce yourself in the comments below. Anyway, I have always been a little bit careful, a lot careful with physical exfoliation, having dry skin. When I exfoliate, my skin then feels exceptionally dry, and I can't explain the feeling that I get. And so when I use a physical exfoliant, it's usually because I can visually see in the mirror that there's some flakiness going on and it could use a little bit of help to get that off. I will be honest, ever since I received the Grown Alchemist exfoliator, I love that one, and it's hard not to exfoliate more frequently. I exfoliate though at most once a week with a physical exfoliant, and then I use AHAs and BHAs. But even then, if you've watched me, you've probably noticed that I use a lot of products. Most of my products are moisturizing, and then the final moisturizer has perhaps an AHA in it, and not even a very, very strong one. I have used glycolic acid and I have used retinol. Those were the strongest AHA exfoliators that I've ever used regularly, and I could definitely see a difference in cell turnover when I was using those. So what I learned from some of the videos below, if I can summarize, is that the skin barrier is the outermost layer of our skin, and it is the barrier, the protector. It keeps moisture in, it keeps pollutants out. If we overly physically exfoliate, we are very much at risk of causing potential damage to our skin barrier. And Dr. Dre, in one of the videos that I'm linking below, talked about how it causes inflammatory hyperpigmentation. For some reason, I'm getting winded in this video. This doesn't typically happen. I'm sorry if you're noticing that. Definitely check out some of the links below in the description box that I'm linking to the experts on this subject. I am not an expert. I have a bachelor's degree, but this is just something that's always felt intuitively right, and now that I have received this to test, I looked into it further. So let's get into this product. That alone does not mean that I think this isn't a good product, okay? So the thing about this product, my first impression was that I was gearing up to film this video like 2 weeks ago, and when I opened it up, I realized batteries not included. I needed batteries for it. So I had to go out and buy some, because who keeps batteries around any longer? So then I started thinking, what did I use to put batteries in? And then I thought, Walkman, CDs, boom boxes, stereos. Then I thought, whoa, I'm time traveling. So I had to grab some AA batteries for this. So this video got delayed. So it looks like this when you open it up. It has 4 brush heads. So a second thing about this, though, I almost forgot as I'm looking at this. A second thing that I am somewhat skeptical about is we all know how yucky our sponges can get, and our loofahs in the shower can get, and just bacteria ridden and
yucky.
So these kinds of brush heads are no different. So when we use something like this, we need to make sure that we really keep it in a dry place and clean it well before we actually go in to use it again. That again is my intuition. I am linking another video below where a dermatologist herself talks about this, and she talks about how the Foreo is better for your skin because it's silicone if you're going to use a device like this. That's the second con, the second hesitation I have about this, particularly for using it on our faces. Now you'll see it has this big brush though. This one's for the body, which is not nearly as sensitive as our face, so I am much more forgiving there and a little bit excited about the idea of using that on my upper thigh and my upper arms to get it nice and smooth. And then it has a pumice stone! This one I'm most excited about, okay? So I love pumicing my feet. We are going to see how this goes. Okay, so to put the batteries in, so it has this little thing here that we open it with, open it from, and it's not very easy. Maybe, you know what, I probably need to read the instructions. Oh, okay, so it just popped up and you do need to give it a good squeeze. It wasn't all that bad, I just didn't want to force it. Oh, it's deep in there. So it needs 4 AA batteries. I thought it was only going to need 2. Curses. Okay, and then it has this little button here. Okay, and it's a very subtle vibration, barely even feel it. So let's see which brush is actually which. So there are 2 of these little guys, you probably saw that. Okay, so one of these little ones is an exfoliating brush and one is a cleaning brush. Okay, so it's pretty obvious which is which because the cleaning brush is much softer. It's very, very soft, very soft. I'm gonna just try this on my face dry. I am going to wash my face so you guys can see how that works. And then I really wanna try the pumice stone, so we're gonna do that too. So. Oh, it kinda tickles a little. Whoa. I have never used one of these before, so this is a really interesting sensation. It is definitely acting like a physical exfoliant. I can't imagine using this every day, particularly if you're someone with sensitive skin and you have problems with rosacea or acne breakouts. I'm not a dermatologist, but this just intuitively does not make sense to me to use on our oh so delicate face skin. Again, I'm really excited about the body and the pumice stone attachment. So we are going to wash our faces. Let's see. It has this instruction booklet. Pamphlet, trifold, I guess is the best word, right? Trifold. And I'm not gonna use the exfoliation brush because even this cleansing brush, which I said feels really, really soft, even that brief moment I put it on my face, I started to feel, okay, yeah, this is abrasive. I can't emphasize enough the idea of over-exfoliation. Over-exfoliation is something that happens and it causes skin damage. Not much instructions. It just says use it on your face gently. It says facial cleansing brush. The facial cleansing brush gently removes excess dirt and makeup residue from your skin and is great to use prior to exfoliation. What? They want me to use that, this, and then the other brush daily? I don't know about this. Gently move the facial cleansing brush across your face while moving in a circular motion. Okay, I'm gonna wet my face with my spray bottle, and then we're going to wash our face. I wouldn't even try this if it weren't for wanting to do it for the YouTube channel. This is probably the one and only time I'm gonna use this on my face. Like I said, I really just don't think that my face wants to be rubbed this roughly all that frequently. So, let's get the mirror. I admit it feels good. Oh, I'll tell you which cleanser I'm using after I do this. I'm trying to turn it off before I take it away from my face so that stuff wouldn't splatter everywhere. If you turn this on with water and soap on it, I'm sure that it just splatters because I want to get to my forehead. Oh, ah, my hair is getting twisted in it. Oh no. Okay. I've been watching a lot of Friends on Netflix with my husband at night, and I think that I just sounded like Phoebe. I think that Phoebe's getting to me. Okay, oh no! Okay, we're gonna finish this up here. Okay, turn off. So that felt rough. At first it felt really nice. I think that I am going to end up extra moisturizing tonight just so that I can give back to my skin barrier. I feel like I just really invaded my skin barrier. Okay, so now I have this very wet brush where if it were to sit in my bathroom, it would acquire a lot of bacterial buildup is my guess. So that's one of the things. The way this functions, okay, let's talk about it functionally. This snaps on and stays on well, but it also snaps on and off really easily. So I do like that. It worked really, really well. I do like the design, feels nice. It's not heavy despite having 4 batteries in it. I really do think that they should make a USB version of this. So the face wash that I'm using is this Namaste Skin Care by Cal Pharma. I got it from FabFitFun. It's decent. It could have better ingredients. There's a PEG in it, and it does foam a little bit if you don't like foaming cleansers, but only a little bit, so it's not as foamy as some others. Okay, so back to this. That is the face part. The body part, though, like I said, I'd be much more open-minded to using this for the body. Look at how big that is. And just doing the same thing on my, you know what, I should probably do it, right? I should do it. Okay, so I put on a tank top so I can test out the body brush. So I'm gonna just spray my arm, get it a little bit wet. And then I typically use bar soap, so I have this travel gel soap that I'm gonna use. Speaking of this, I also don't tend to soap my entire body too much. In researching a lot for this video, I feel a little proud of myself because I learned that some of the things that I was doing intuitively, like when I shower, I really, most of the time, just wash the important parts. I watched one of the videos below by Dr. Dre where she talks about how the important parts of our body are more tolerant of soap, that our skin is not very tolerant of soap in general. The pH balance in soaps, which is kind of silly, is usually a little too alkaline for how acidic our skin is. So I highly suggest watching some of the videos that I'm posting below. They are really super informative and educational. So while this is running all over the place, I have been talking too much. So let's just try this now. It's pretty harsh. If you are one of those people who has bumps on your arms, I used to get them years and years ago and they just kind of went away as I got older, but I think that this would probably help. In those videos, I learned that that is just clogged hair follicles with dead skin cells. And that exfoliating can be very helpful there. I can feel it's kind of starting to hurt. I've been doing this too long. Okay, let's turn that off. I don't know that I'm enjoying that as much as I thought I would. I'm going to, not on camera, try it on my butt, and then I'll let you know how that works. Okay, so go figure. I like the way it feels best on my butt. It felt the least abrasive, probably because there's plenty of padding there so that it doesn't feel so harsh. Overall, this really functions quite well. So I want to try the last attachment. It is the pumice stone, which I'm the most excited about. I keep a pumice stone in my shower. These, as far as I know, do not acquire bacteria when left in warm, damp places, such as the bathroom. I'm going to pop this on, and I am going to try it on my foot. It's not, my foot isn't soaked, but I'm just going to spray it, soaked as in like soaked for 10 minutes and softened up, but I will spray a little water and just try it really quickly. So it looks like this. And you know what, I'll take you guys and I'll angle you so you can see it. Oh my goodness, never mind, I've never been so self-conscious about my feet before. The lighting and the camera, it just looked weird. So I'm just gonna try it out and I'll tell you guys how the experience is. You're gonna see my reaction. I am one of those people who's tickled. Oh my gosh, this is amazing. Wow. If for no other reason you purchase this, I recommend it for the pumice stone. Oh my gosh, it worked so beautifully. My foot wasn't even soaked. I can't get, after my foot soaked and I use just the regular pumice stone with my hand, I can't get it to go as well as that just went. I don't really have callousy feet, but oh my gosh. I would say you don't really need this for any other reason but at home pedicures. I don't recommend it for the face for the reasons that I talked about in the beginning. It's okay on the arm and the butt and the thigh and the body exfoliator, but I do prefer a scrub on my body, and I actually, a washcloth does the trick. I used to hate when my husband would say that, but the more I've learned, the more, of course, he is right. That was incredible, and it was like two, I'm gonna do the other foot. You know what? I think I need to wet it. Wow. I'm just doing my heel. I'm into it. Woo! I am in, yeah, wow, okay. So 70% off with my code in the description box below. Again, I don't really recommend using brushes like this on your face. And again, if you use one and you love it and you have a different experience and you totally disagree with me, always feel free to disagree with me and share ideas and comments. I am not the end all be all. I am just going off of intuition and what I see from dermatologists on YouTube as far as my review is concerned for the brushes on skin. But this pumice stone attachment is everything. I am so happy about it. Okay, wow. I had some other things to say, and I'm so blown away by the pumice stone attachment, which I was really excited to begin with. From the start, I thought, oh my gosh, I hope that that's as amazing as I think it's gonna be, and it is definitely. So it's the Radiant Spin Care System. It's Duvol.com. I got contacted recently by somebody who wanted to send me their gummy vitamins, and it was also from Duvol. I declined that one because I'm taking prenatal vitamins. I don't feel like I can give you a very solid review on vitamins. I felt like doing this one, so I said, yes, sure, send it to me. And oh my god, I'm so excited about the pumice attachment. If you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing. I think that I don't have anything more to say. I hope you have a wonderful day. I love you all, and I will see you later. Bye!